When the Dimestore fishermen journeyed to the northern peninsula of Newfoundland, we knew we would be close to where Vikings landed and actually be in a place that Jacques Cartier explored. The town of St. Anthony is one of the oldest and most remote inhabited areas of Newfoundland. We took a boat onto the Atlantic Ocean and experienced much more than we originally bargained for. Looking down the coastline at towering cliff sentinels was awe-inspiring. We also had a chance to wet a line. In Newfoundland, we met kind, hardworking people who really know how to get together to celebrate life. St. Anthony is where we met Smilin' Jon Simmons. Smilin' Jon has a way with the guitar and the song. He's an outdoorsman who genuinely loves his home and his community, and we had the privilege of spending time with him as he described his home for us during a drive.
The town itself has some fantastic walking trails, viewing platforms. You know, Dr. Grenfell, who was a missionary doctor here, came here in the late 1800s. Now his house is a historic site. They have an interpretation center. You know, it's just fantastic. And you walk up some of these trails up to Tea House Hill, where him and his colleagues would go at times to be able to just to kind of relax, meditate, and enjoy the panoramic view.
How old would you say that St. Anthony is as a town?
St. Anthony just celebrated its 50th year as an incorporated town. But obviously it's been here a lot longer than that. I mean, the local Grenfell Co-op is nearly 100 years old as a society. And, you know, that's just one example of what Dr. Grenfell did, not only as a doctor, but as a visionary, as a missionary. He made so many people's lives so much greater by what he did. And not just St. Anthony alone, but I mean the whole north coast of Newfoundland and in Labrador. And he truly was an amazing man. As a doctor and as a fundraiser, I mean, he was able to connect with some of the most powerful people around the world. And through his efforts, I mean, the International Grenfell Association was formed and is still alive and well today and does amazing things.
After our drive, we went to Jon's Glacier Manor Resort for a traditional Newfoundlander's dish.
Who wants me to eat this meal quickly?
Take two.
Unbelievable. Fisherman's brews. This is traditional Newfoundland fare. And it's made up of cod and hard bread, self-explanatory. Right. Pork scrunchions and onions. And Jon was explaining to me that this is a traditional Newfoundland meal. It's been around, it's age old. And this is fantastic. I've got to tell you, buddy, this is absolutely unbelievable.
It's a great meal, and it's a favorite, of course, not only among Newfoundlanders, but, you know, for our visiting tourists, they just absolutely love the fisherman's brews.
And now, pork scrunchions is actually salted pork stripped.
Yes.
And fried up.
Sure. You take it, you cut up in small cubes, fry it up in a nice cast iron frying pan with some onions, take that and mix it in with your fish and brews. Voila.
And we've also got, for a little bit of flavor taste here, some pickles with mustard and... unbelievable. Hey, I'm getting to the meal right now. Fisherman's brews in Newfoundland. This is good stuff.
Oh,